I'll quote two sentences. They say, in connection with leaders, sorry, in conversation with leaders at Infosys, Reliance, Tata, Mahindra and Mahindra, Avantis, Pharma and many others, a picture emerged of a distinctive Indian model. This is what they say. And I quote once again, Western leaders would do well to understand the managerial approaches that have fueled the rise of India's largest companies and mindfully adapt them. In fact, they are suggesting the Western corporates to adapt Indian leadership management practices. They say, what is the reason for this? They say, the Indian leadership approach arose from the unique circumstances of the Indian economy and the society. And this is due to our culture. So we have to understand that here in India, we have a Bharatiya functioning model. Our professor mentioned about Angus Madison. You know, Angus Madison shows in the last 2,000 years, in fact, for about 17 centuries, more than 17 centuries, India has been the leader. 15th century, of course, we had a dip. 16th century, again, we came up. So for about 1700 years, more than 1700 years, we were the number one economy. We were the most sustainable economy. What was the reason? This is the basis. Savings, culture, families. And in a period of just 200 years, it was destroyed. And again, Bharat is re-emerging without we ourselves noticing it. We have not understood this. Without we ourselves noticing it, India is re-emerging. Indian economy is re-emerging. Many times without the intervention of the state. In fact, sometimes there is a professor, economics professor in Tamil Nadu, he was the director of Madras Institute of Development Studies. He is from a place called Karur, whom some of you might have heard. These green cloths, table cloths, they are all coming from Karur. Again, an important, export cluster. He said when he was writing about Karur, despite the Tamil Nadu government, Karur has succeeded. And this is true for many other places in India also, despite, because government many times gives troubles. But in spite of it, they have been growing. So Indian economy has been growing without we ourselves knowing about it. And now what opportunities? There are enormous opportunities before us. You know, India is emerging as the most potential economy. Now our people are doing business across the world. Our lesser known clusters, we all know that as far as diamond industry is concerned, we are dominating it. In Antwerp, Belgium, more than 60% of the international diamond trade takes place through Indians, Patels and Jains. So we have enormous business opportunities today. But we have opportunities in other places also, which we have not noticed. For example, we are yet to recognize some of our people, their skills, centers. You know, wherever we visit, we have seen these textile clusters doing excellently well. There are hundreds of clusters in India which we have not recognized them. In fact, we have to recognize and positive interference from the policymakers, government should be necessary. Then these sectors will come up. So there are enormous opportunities for us. But what is the threat? Threat is failure of the intellectual class, failure of the academic institutions, professors like us, to recognize these functioning economic systems, Bharatiya systems that is here, functioning here. We have failed to study them, to understand them, and then to disseminate, to help the policymakers to take decisions. So it is our responsibility to study, to recognize, and then discuss about it in forum. That is why, using this forum, I make an appeal to Prabhutva Bharat, especially my friend Chaitanya and Sachin, that you have to take up study of this Belgavi, which is a very important industrial center built by the local people. You have to take up the study, and then within 1 year, you have to produce the report so that if at all any help is necessary, we can go to the policymakers. But it is our duty. In fact, I don't have time, otherwise I would have told you. We have helped many of these clusters with small interventions. They may not need much money. They may not need much intervention. You know, I come from Coimbatore, which is closer to Ooty. In Ooty, we have this tea industry. In the late 90s, Ooty tea industry was having serious problem. So they did not know what to do. They approached one of the top five consultants, international consultants in those days. They came there, charged 10 lakh of rupees fees, and then produced a report, gave it to them. and which none of them could read. So when we went, they told us, sir, this is the report. We are not able to understand, so you have to help us. You know, we did only one thing. We selected 10 teachers, faculty members. No, not 10 teachers. 10 students and 2 faculty members from in and around Ooty, asked them to study the industry for about 15 days. And then they came out with the report. And then we approached our mentor, Sri S. Gurumurthy, and then we had a discussion with them. And then we suggested some positive things to them. You will be surprised to know, in the first year itself, they were getting 5 rupees more than per kg. Farmers were getting 5 rupees more than what they were getting earlier. To the customers, they reduced the market price to 20 rupees. They were able to sell in the market. In spite of it, their company, we asked them to promote a company. The company earned 3 crore profit within 1 year. For all this, we spent only 5,000 rupees. Only 5,000 rupees. So we have solutions here. Our people know the solutions. For example, for Belgavi industry, people know the solutions. You need not go to some place, bring outside expert. You know solutions. Only thing is you need some intervention, some articulation mechanism. Otherwise, you will be able to solve. So this is my appeal to you. What should we do? First of all, we have to recognize that there are functioning systems here. Otherwise, an economy which was termed as a very poor economy 70 years back would not have come up in such a way in a period of 7 decades. In fact, if you see the economic history of the world, no other country in the world has made such a U-turn in a period of just 7 decades. 7 decades. So we have strong fundamentals. We have strong fundamentals. We have our family system. We have our community orientation. We have our culture to pack up. This is what we have to remember. So first of all, we have to understand this and then start looking at them afresh. Thank you very much.